King Zedekiah blinded. God promised King David that the Messianic kingdom should come through his line. And for several centuries, no king reigned in Jerusalem except David's posterity. The last was King Zedekiah. Of him God declared through the prophet, O thou profane and wicked prince, whose time is come that iniquity should have an end. Take off the diadem, remove the crown. This shall not be the same. I will overturn it until he come whose right it is, and I will give it to him. This was another way of saying that there would be no more kings of David's line until Messiah. This has been fulfilled during the long period of 2,518 years, from then until now. All later kings were tributary and none of David's line. When God took his kingdom from Zedekiah, he told him through one of the prophets that he would be carried prisoner by Nebuchadnezzar to Babylon, and by another prophet that he would never see Babylon. Both prophecies came true, for Nebuchadnezzar caused his eyes to be put out when a prisoner, and in that condition he went to Babylon. But God promised to David, of the fruit of thy loins shall a king sit upon thy throne forever, was not broken. The message to Zedekiah merely indicates that the throne ceased to be recognized of the Lord and would thus remain until Messiah's kingdom. But the first advent of Jesus did not fulfill this prophecy, for although Jesus is the Messiah, he has not yet entered upon his kingly office. Jesus began his service as a priest. He offered up himself. His offering continues these 1900 years. Since Pentecost, he has been accepting and offering as his members such as present their bodies living sacrifices. These joint sacrifices are promised as members of the body of Christ, a share in the messianic reign of 1,000 years for the blessing of Israel and the whole world.